I did, and I still do, but there's a blueprint for taking Treylon Burks out of the game, and that was evident Saturday night. And they're going to have a hard time scoring without Treylon Burks, who has 36% of their catches, who is a matchup nightmare that you can put in so many different spots. Obviously, Alabama has the guys to match up with him, and if you can bracket him or double him, he can be taken out of the game, and that really puts a lot of pressure on the Arkansas run game, which is really good, but doesn't have an elite player. I was so impressed with KJ Jefferson's ability to keep plays alive. You know, for folks who haven't seen him, he's a 250-pound quarterback. He's got a strong arm, and he keeps plays alive because, you know, it's kind of like trying to bring down Roethlisberger, although he's a lot more mobile than that, and he can take off and he can extend plays. That's how they got their game-tying touchdown on Saturday night. Just defensive end bounced right off of him, and he's able to shove him to the side, roll out, and hit Dominic Johnson, the running back, down the sideline for the game-tying touchdown. So I think it could be a much more interesting game than most people assume just when you put the logos out there on the field. I mean, we all know that everyone's there are different levels in life, right? Not just in football, but in life. I mean, some people stay at the graduate, some people stay at the town place. That's just the way it is, and you have to embrace that and know where you stand.